In this video, we will go over the protocol to thaw induced pluripotent cells. Before thawing the cells, make sure all the necessary material is set up inside the biosafety cabinet, and add 9 milliliters of warm DMEM F12 media with anti-anti to a 15 milliliter sterile conical tube. This media will be used to resuspend the cells after thawing. This step is important to remove the dimethyl sulfoxide used to cryopreserve the cells. iPSCs are kept in liquid nitrogen tanks for long-term storage. When retrieving the vial, it's important to use the proper personal protective equipment to avoid injury. You should wear a face shield, insulating gloves, and a lab coat. Transfer some liquid nitrogen to a liquid nitrogen transfer container and add the cryovial to it. This will keep the vial frozen until cells are ready to be thawed. Using forceps, carefully remove the cryovial from the container and transfer it to the water bath. Start thawing the vial by gently shaking it inside the 37 degrees Celsius water bath. Be careful to not wet the cap of the cryovial. Immerse the vial in the warm water and keep agitating it. The frozen cell pellet will thaw gradually. Check every 30 seconds to see how much ice is left. You might need to repeat this procedure a couple of times. When only a small ice pellet is left in the vial, spray it with 70% ethanol and bring it inside the biosafety cabinet. A glass serological pipette is used to prevent the cell clumps from breaking down and to avoid forming a single cell suspension. Using a 5 milliliter glass serological pipette, slowly transfer the cells into a 15 milliliter tube containing DMEM F12 with anti-anti that was prepared previously. Rinse the vial with 1 milliliter of DMEM F12 with anti-anti and transfer this media to the same tube. Close the tube and gently homogenize the cell suspension by inverting the tube a few times. Centrifuge the cells for 3 minutes at 1,200 RPM. After the centrifuging step, a cell pellet is formed at the bottom of the tube as shown. Long exposure of cells to dimethyl sulfoxide can lead to cell death. To avoid it, remove as much as possible of the supernatant containing dimethyl sulfoxide by using vacuum aspiration. Make sure to not disturb the cell pellet. The cell pellet should still be visible at the bottom of the tube as shown. The next step is to prepare the media to culture the iPSCs. When thawing iPSCs, we suggest adding ROCK inhibitor in the culture media on the first day of culture. This increases the survival of cells. Prepare 8 milliliters of the appropriate iPSC culture media supplemented with 10 micromoles of ROCK inhibitor. Replace the cap and invert the tube a few times to mix. Aspirate the Matrodel coating solution from the culture dish. Make sure to aspirate the solution from a corner of the dish to avoid scratching the dish coating. With a serological pipette, take 2 milliliters of media with ROCK inhibitor and slowly add it to the tube containing the cells. Take the remaining 6 milliliters of the media with ROCK inhibitor and add it directly to the dish. This is important to avoid the dish from drying up. Using a 5 milliliter glass serological pipette, resuspend the cells in the 2 milliliters of media previously added to the tube. When resuspending the cells, it is important to be gentle in order to preserve the cell clumps and to avoid making a single cell suspension. We advise to pipette the cell suspension up and down no more than 5 times. Add cells to the dish slowly and rock the dish gently to spread the cells around it. It is important to clearly label your dish with relevant information such as the cell line name, date of plating, type of media used, and any other information you deem important. Right after plating the cells in the dish, carefully bring your dish to the microscope and verify the size of the cell clumps as well as their density. When checking the cells under the microscope, keep in mind that it is important to have a high density of clumps, as not all of them will attach. This is an image of good quality plated cells right after plating. Ideally, cell clumps should be formed by around 10 to 50 cells. After checking the cells, carefully transfer the dish to a 37 degrees Celsius incubator with 5% of CO2 and leave the cells undisturbed for about 24 hours. After 24 hours in culture, most cells have attached. It is normal to see some floating. These are dead cells. These cells will be removed during media change. To change the media of the cells, remove the conditioned media containing ROCK inhibitor by vacuum aspiration and replace it with fresh media without ROCK inhibitor. Follow the manufacturer's protocol for the subsequent media changes. Keep checking the culture, ideally daily, to assure the cells are growing, forming colonies, and that no microbial contamination is present. Assess cultures also for the presence of spontaneous differentiation and to determine the best time for passaging.